I am a technical group supervisor, which is the lowest form of management at JPL, and I'm proud of it. My joy this evening is to introduce a young man that I had the privilege of hiring after being assigned a very ambitious project called Eyes on the Solar System. It's a project to allow you to explore the solar system using your web browser. But I needed somebody. So I asked another one of our young engineers, hey, do you know anybody that can program well? He said, sure, you should talk to my friend John. So I spoke with John, I hired him, and assigned him this project just to bide his time while the other programmers finished Eyes on the Earth. But in the short time that John was given this project, he worked so hard and so well that he established himself as the team lead and went on to design and be the chief developer of a piece of software that he is going to demonstrate to you shortly. So without further delay, I would like to introduce John Nguyen.
Hi, everyone. As mentioned before, my name is Viet Nguyen, and I've been working for JPL for about a year now. And to be honest, I'm actually working at the organization that I dreamed of working for. When I tell young students like yourselves advice for school, I always try to tell them, join a student group. And there's two good reasons for that. One is, you learn a lot in your classes. And until you actually apply that knowledge that you've learned, you haven't really learned it yet. And these student groups are great because they give you a means to apply what you've learned in student projects. So the group that I joined, well, we made a plane. We did aerospace engineering and we made a plane. That was our project. Other student groups, they made rockets. And when they actually applied that knowledge, they knew it spot on. The second reason why student groups are great is the people you meet, the friends you meet, the connections you make. And you gotta realize something, the connections you make generate opportunities down the line. And I have two personal examples about that. So when I was a student at UCLA, JPL was looking for an academic part-time hire. Well, they contacted a student group organizer at UCLA who forwarded to a student group leader, who forwarded to another student group leader who happened to be my friend in AIAA. He forwarded the email to me. And immediately, once I saw JPL on there, I sent my resume off because I want to work for JPL. That's what I want to do. And luckily, they accepted me. And I did academic part-time internship at UCLA, or sorry, at JPL. And I did that for 9 months as a systems engineer on the Mars Science Laboratory. Now think about this. I was a young student, and I got to do systems engineering on the Mars Science Laboratory. That was that big six-wheeled rover that Jim Adams showed. I got to work on that, and it was incredible. Now, that only lasted 9 months because I had to go back to UCLA and finish up my education. I wanted to graduate, of course. And I graduated June 2009. Now, the problem is June 2009, that's in the middle of the recession, and JPL couldn't guarantee me a job after I graduated. And a lot of my friends, we were anxious. We weren't sure if we were going to have a job. Well, I was actually lucky enough to have a job offer when I graduated. But the thing was, it wasn't for JPL. It was for another engineering firm, and it wasn't in aerospace. But I love aerospace. And so I took a gamble. I told myself, you know what? These passions mean so much to me that I actually turned down that job offer. Luckily, I have pretty supportive parents, but my friends, they thought I was crazy. Because, you know, it was really hard to get a job. They told me, you should have taken that. Well, I was unemployed, obviously, and I was unemployed for about 6 months. But, and I want to get back to why connections are so important. 6 months into my unemployment, a friend called me, just as Kevin mentioned, my friend Anton. He's an old high school friend. He called me and he said, you know what? Our group is looking for a new programmer. Do you think you can do it? I jumped right on it. It was at JPL. It was doing programming, which I love. It had to do with space. Of course I'm going to jump on that. And so I got the job, as Kevin mentioned, and we've been working for the past about a year working on the Eyes on the Solar System program. And so now I've kind of come full circle, because as a kid, I was inspired to be a space enthusiast because of those pretty pictures. Well, now I'm in a position to inspire a whole new generation of space enthusiasts, hopefully you guys out here, because I'm working on Eyes on the Solar System. And I hope that after seeing the solar system for yourself, you'll be inspired as I was when I was a kid. Thank you.